come and some may go, he will surely pass. When the one that left us here returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Come on, people, now smile on your brother. Everybody get together, try to love one another.
Breath as one, and just for a moment, take a moment of silence and gratitude. Look to our music makers who are such an integral part of our community of uplifting spirit, helping to open that portal that we all, when we walk in here, hope to step into, a journey. The theme, let the rivers of strange fire run, let the rivers run. So when we enter these doors, let's feel the flow of what's happening. And let's give gratitude to the gifted members of our community. We have any newcomers? Anybody here for your first time? We'd like to welcome you so, so much. And for everyone that's out there online, we certainly appreciate all the energy and the attention and the value that you place on your time to be here with us. Thank you. Have you ever been moved to silence? Whether it's through joy or frustration or sadness or sometimes just out of the not knowing. And for the longest time, that has being a symbol around here at Jubilee of keeping the main thing has always been the main thing. But it reminds us of the great mystery. And part of the great mystery is we're entering in today in the awareness that's arising that's here for us. The seeds that were written for this Sunday, that the rivers of strange fire run. Why in this time is this being presented to us? Are we listening to the messages that are coming to us that have been preordained, that somewhere in the future said, somewhere on this day, this is going to be the topic. And here we are in this time where strange fire is burning all over the planet. How many of you taken the time to look at the new Webb telescope and all the wondrous things that are going on out there in the universe? So much wisdom and light. As we come in through these doors and as we come to this fire, as we come to this river of fire, this igniting of the flow of spirit and blood, of lifeblood, not just the humanness that lives inside of us. The lifeblood that flows inside the cloud people and the thunder beings when they announce themselves when they come. It's like someone knocking at the door saying, I'm here. So we're here in these moments of strange fire to find a flow, to define what it really means to us, not what we've been told, but how do we evolve as the rivers flow, as we spread across the planet and nurture the planet with our wisdom. So in a good way, I ask you to rise and let's feed the hungry. And for all of those of you that are online, thank you for your prayers and all that you do for us in a good way.
In the middle of the highway walking in the middle of the highway walking in the middle.
Again, Jubilee, it's still me. Well, the strange fire has already begun to burn because my dyslexia kicked in again.
Oh, yay for dyslexia!
So in this moment of let the rivers run and whatever that definition means to us, upon learning that that's what the theme was for today, I instantly do what most people do. I Googled it and found Bible verses from Leviticus, and I found some fire and brimstone stuff out there, which is right down my alley because I am a recovering Southern Baptist. My father was a Southern Baptist minister that I still have singed hair on my head from my childhood. So in this moment, as we get ready to honor the directions, let's take an opportunity to really understand and really take out these things that we have on our altar of life, these things that we invoke with our power and our belief, our faith, our trust, these things of the earth that we look to channel the energies of the earth for us. So as we honor the directions, let's remember the core source of where we look to these things, to the ancestors and to all of the things that have come before. Face to the east, please. Oho, spirits of the East. We're in such gratitude to be in your presence. Thank you for your continued journey to reassure us that your love and your divine light and guidance is always here for us. The warmth of your embrace, the comfort of your smile, the shining light that leads us sometimes in the darkness of our lives. Thank you. Thank you for being that light that reminds us of what lives inside each and every one of us. And as we join our light together as one indigenous tribe of this earth, to appreciate how we grow the light as one, to shine like the stars in the sky. In a good way, we thank you. Now, face to the south, please. Oho, spirits of the south, to all the beings of the water nations, we thank you. We thank you, rain people and cloud people and thunder beings, for gracing us with your presence. All the greenery and all the life of earth is so happy that you're here. Thank you, water of life and the rivers of strange fire and the rivers of wisdom and kindness and compassion, all the names that we know that define the flows of energy in our life. Know in our hearts and know in our silence that we give back to the vibration of water that feeds the heart of Mother Earth, that gives life to each and every one of us. Thank you, Water Nation, for all that you give to us to quench our thirst for the great mystery in a good way. Face to the west, please. Oho, ancestors of the west, to all of those that have gone before, we thank you. We thank you for igniting the river of fire. We thank you for guiding us in a path that leads that river to greatness. As we learn in these times that sometimes can be challenging, stand with us. Stand with us in your greatness, in your wisdom of things past, of the times whenever these things face the people of the earth before our time. Help us to remember their prayers, their fortitude, to endeavor and to persevere. Share with us that wisdom and the guidance through the wind, through your songs and your stories and your memories. We ask you in this time to come and stand with us and guide us in a good way. Face to the north. Oho, spirits of the north. To all the greetings and all the gratitude that's contained within the wind spirits, we thank you. We thank you for the miracle that is each and every breath. The lesson of sacred reciprocity with each breath that we take in and as we give back with each release, exhale of life. Contributions that are given and received. Thank you, Wind Nation, for carrying these gifts for us. Thank you for being that energy and that power and that medicine of earth and the unseen and the great mystery. For taking this sacred alchemy of spirit and prayer and joining us all together as one. Thank you, Wind Nation, for your breath of life in a good way. And face the center, please. And again, as we go back to the core of who we are as a people of this planet, of these prayers that surround us, and all these starlight beings that represent all of those that have come before, know that we stand here as one community and one voice, that we come with honor and love and respect as we agreed to in the very beginning of time. Know that we still stand here with that honor, love, and respect. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh.
In the midst of the morning, we open to all of the gifts of the day. We open our hearts to take it all in and sing of the beauty within. Oh, hear the earth tell that all shall be well.
Faces and all you old faces. I mean that in the kindest way. Jubilee in action. That's where we find out what's going on at Jubilee, what you can participate in, how you can help make the world a better place. Okay, we've got several things coming up. You know, everyone should know CPR and basic first aid. Don't you agree? Okay. Well, here's a really good reason to get certified now. Nicola Roma Thorell is holding a 21-day online CPR and basic first aid challenge starting September 1st, with half of the $98 fee going to Jubilee. It's just 15 minutes a day for 21 days, and after that, you'll be fully certified. Noelle will donate the $48.50 to Jubilee. So that's one way you can help make the world a better place. You never know when you might be called into action. If you haven't tuned in to any of Yona FrenchHawk's free storytelling events on the Deep Time Network, there's still time to do so on Tuesday, August 16th at 10 a.m., and on Thursday, August 26th at 7 p.m. So, next month is full of Bring Your Own Talent events. We've got belly dancing lessons coming up on August 22nd, a Kirtan concert on September 11th, Paula Hanke and Peggy Ratuse, their Love is a Rose, Linda Ronstadt tribute.
You better come. You better fill the place.
That's happening on September 13th. And there's a bunch of other stuff later in the month. So please check out the BYOT little tab on the website. And actually, if there's anything you want to know about what's going on at Jubilee, go to the website. Michelle does an awesome job keeping it updated, and it's the go-to place for all your information. Okay, so this year's Story Medicine for Racial Healing class begins August 24th. This was started by Maida Commerce, who has passed the baton to Heidi Wood to teach this class. And Ron Katz continues to offer an amazing amount of information on social justice matters. Details on how to subscribe to his three newsletters is on the JIA page on the website. The August Jubilee Board meeting is tomorrow at 6 p.m. Jubilants are invited to observe either in person or at 46 Wall Street or on Zoom. Let's see, Summer Orchestra. Eric, come tell us about it.
Hello, everyone. Next Saturday afternoon, 3 o'clock, is our first Jubilee Summer Orchestra concert since 2019. The last time we did this, we had Howard rounding out his tenure playing the piano. We had Paula singing with us in 2019. We're really glad to be back. We've got the full orchestra here. We've been having rehearsals with like 50, 60 people. If you haven't seen the orchestra, it's really fun to be in an orchestra concert in this space because you sort of feel like you're sitting inside the orchestra. It's pretty amazing. This year we're doing a program called Lincoln Highway. And Lincoln Highway celebrates the life of Abraham Lincoln, the leadership of Abraham Lincoln in a divided country, which seems relevant now somehow. And also it's also a celebration of the unity of America in the midst of diversity. Lincoln Highway, if you don't know, goes from New York all the way to San Francisco. And we've got a really cool piece written by a South Carolina composer that traces American music all the way across the country throughout history. We've also got music from John Williams, the music from the film Lincoln, that Daniel Day-Lewis acted in. And we've also got some music by Florence Price. The concert will be here Saturday, 3 o'clock. Tickets are $15 only at the door. And if you haven't come, you know, this is a rare opportunity to see the orchestra in this space, maybe an endangered species. So I just encourage you to bring a friend and come celebrate Lincoln Highway.
Do not miss the orchestra concert. It is always awesome. We have Elizabeth to give us a board update.
Good morning, Jubilee. My name is Elizabeth Likas. For those of you that maybe are first-timer here or watching on YouTube or one of those virtual platforms, I've been a board member for the past 3+ years, and you have been probably hearing a lot about the board, and I'm going to tell you a couple of things that are going on right now. One is that we have been trying to get back and align with our bylaws, things that in practice have not happened much, whether it was COVID, whether it was just transition of ministers, lots of things going on. One of those things is that we, every summer, pick new board members. We have nominations. I got up here several times. You were probably tired of seeing me in April and May. Asking for those that might prayerfully consider serving as a board member. So we typically, what the bylaws say is that we have a slate, the board consents and has a slate of nominees ready for our annual meeting in June. Well, for those of you that came to the annual meeting in June or tuned into that, we did not have a slate ready at that point. We could not vote at the membership. The membership could not vote at the annual meeting because we were still trying to gather people and inform them of what was going on and get nominations. So we've spent July and the early part of August doing that, and right now we have two board nominees that the board has consented to at last month's meeting, but it needs an approval process by our membership. So we had to suspend the bylaws to say, not during the annual meeting, but as soon as we had some ready. And then what will happen in the coming months is probably have at least two more nominees once they go through the process that we'll bring back before you. Jubilee is a community where you have a say, and we want to make that happen consistently. So I'm going to explain to you our very high-tech voting booth process. There's a table in the hospitality room, and it has pictures of two nominees. One of them is Louise Slater. Louise, will you stand? And one is Wiley Garrett over here. So Wiley and Louise both have a lot of board history, interesting jobs throughout the years, education, ministry, just a whole slew of skills that we're excited about. So there's a table with a bag. Couldn't find any shoeboxes in my house. There's a bag with an opening. There are two slips of paper. This is green, you approve. Just grab one, stick it in the bag. If you do not approve for some reason, put the pink one in there. But I also encourage you to find me or find another board member to tell us what your concerns are. But that's sort of the way we're going to do this process this morning, so we will approve. And you can vote, too. Okay.
Don't do it.
Oh. Okay, Linda, you can get him. Just wanted to say hello. So that's our high-tech process. Thank you so much for being a part of that. And the second thing, just more as a continuation, is a request from all of you to continue sending prayers, thoughts, the discerning wisdom and spirit to guide the board through the coming months, as we have a lot of transitions, a lot of plans, and a lot of decisions. You will be hearing soon about the next step in the process of selling the building and various investors and the realtor, but I'm not the one to give that report because I don't know all the details. I think that's it for now. Thank you so much.
So that's Jubilee in Action. Think about ways that you can get involved and become an active member of the community, and we are going to grow and thrive like you've never seen it. Thank you. I get to introduce our next. Our gift today was supposed to be given by John David Short, but he was not able to make it this morning. So Bruce Mulkey has a little prayer for us. Bruce, where are you? I've got to open those eyes in the back of my head.
Good morning, Jubilant. This morning, I'm going to share a prayer from a book called Gorillas of Grace, Prayers for the Battle by Ted Loder. The title of the prayer is Pry Me Off Dead Center. O persistent God, deliver me from assuming your mercy is gentle. Pressure me that I may grow more human, not through the lessening of my struggles, but through an expansion of them that will undam me and unbury my gifts. Deepen my hurt until I learn to share it and myself openly and my needs honestly. Sharpen my fears until I name them and release the power I have locked in them and they in me. Accentuate my confusion until I shed those grandiose expectations that divert me from the small, glad gifts of the now and the here and the me. Expose my shame where it shivers, crouched behind the curtains of propriety until I can laugh at last through my common frailties and failures, laugh my way toward becoming whole. Deliver me from just going through the motions and wasting everything I have, which is today. A chance, a choice, my creativity, your call. O persistent God, let how much it all matters pry me off dead center so that I am moved inside to tears or sighs or screams or smiles or dreams. They will be real, and I will be in touch with who I am and who you are and who my sisters and brothers are. Thank you.
Thank you, Bruce. If everyone would, again, let's take a collective breath and really be with what is just being offered to us through message, what this community of Jubilee, how we express ourselves through our actions. Thank you, Bruce, for that beautiful message. And I encourage anyone that wants to come grab a bowl or a bell. I'm a bell ringer myself. And to circle back to the beginning of where we talk about the core source of where we look to for our prayers, for the answers to our prayers, and maybe not even the answers, but at least the realizations that are offered to us in our understanding in this time, We call upon the ancientness, that first language of vibration, when we were inside the womb of Mother Earth, and maybe the first language we heard was the vibration of our mother's voice of giving us love inside the womb. Or maybe the father putting his hands on the womb of the mother and speaking that same love and vision. And for all of you out there watching this online, and for all of you, know that the prayers that we have here, where Jay will be here to pray with you, but also the prayers in the prayer room, we want to acknowledge all the names, all the calls that have gone out for good health, for people that are in darkness looking for guidance. Know that we, Jubilee, are that light that these people are looking for. Maybe the only way they can express themselves is to write it and put it on that wall. So be present with this moment and give the best of yourself. First you pray for the hungry, then you feed the hungry. That's how prayer works. And there are people out there hungry for answers, that are hungry for our compassion and for our light and our warmth. In a good way, let's offer the best of ourselves.
Requested by Yona to learn this next song to present to you as a gift. It's the perfect song for the message of Strange Fire. It's called Strange Fire, and it's by the Indigo Girls. Yeah. Terry's gonna help me with this. Questions that lie in your path. I want to harbor you from the anger, find a refuge of the path. This is a message, a message of love. Take in your own authority.
Thank you. And once again, everyone, can we just take a deep breath and just rub our hands together and just warm up this love and appreciation and look toward our band. Band, if you would stand up, please. Know that we love and we honor you. Everybody send them love and energy and gratitude. Thank you. And with the same energy, we also like to, in this moment, give gratitude to Elizabeth Likas. Please stand up, Elizabeth. And we have other outgoing board members, Jenny Farthing, if you're here, Vanna Allen. Just want to say thank you and so much gratitude to you. Love, light, and love to you. Thank you. Today's reading. Listen to these holy words. But if believers are to grow in Christ's likeness, they must be continually filled with the Spirit, allowing Creator's power to permeate their lives so all they think, say, and do reflects the divine light. And this comes from us to us from a book called The Danger of Offending the Holy Spirit with Counterfeit Worship. This is sacred wisdom and holy word.
Thanks be to all that is wise and holy.
All creation is wisdom and holy word.
All creation sings of God. Wisdom and God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jubilee, for being here. And as many of you know, I'm pretty much a shoot from the hip kind of guy. And I always take notes and I always end up leaving them sitting here. And I have these little reminders to myself. Number one, being a timer, because we all relied on this sacred piece of equipment to guide us. So let's understand that in this time as we embark on the river here, strange fire, where does it exactly come from? From what I understand, its exact origins are about two brothers that take it upon themselves because they've seen their father being blessed and anointed by Christ to go out and do Christ's work on the name of God. And just because they witnessed this and just because that they were the sons of this anointed being, they felt entitled to go do it on their own. Thus, creating words such as blasphemy, things that are done against the name of Christ and the true value of things that are anointed to us and gifted to us. As we embark on this river of strange fire, let's return to the water of the womb. Where does the river begin? Where is its tap source? Where in the earth, like we go in these mountains, how many of you know of the little water spot in Black Mountain? You go out there and fill your water jugs up and get you some good fresh water. Where does it come from? Why do we drink it? Because it's rich with nutrients. It comes from the earth. Just like they say the local honey, eat the local honey because it contains all the pollens and all those things that we might be allergic to here in this land. This is wisdom given to us by the earth. Medicine. We call this maybe holistic medicine. Learning from the earth. So as we embark on this journey of this river of strange fire, let's understand where the water comes from. Was the water originally on fire? Good one. And is it that fire, that inner liquid fire, that whenever we go to these places and we draw the water from these places and we drink and we allow the medicine to flow, the coolness of the water and how it refreshes us? Of how we allow it to go in. Imagine the seeds and the flowers and all the plants that you have in your house when you, every day you go out and you pour water and say loving things to them. Envision in your mind energetically what they're going to grow into and be beautiful. So how about next time we take a drink of that water, we nurture ourselves in the same way? That when we water ourselves, we say, oh, good morning, Yona. You're so beautiful. The future is so bright. And here's some water for you because you're going to need it for this journey. And there's going to be times whenever the sun's going to shine. And there's going to be times whenever the sun's going to get hot. Because as we become more vulnerable in the river and journey of strange fire on the river, as the heat begins to warm up, I don't know about you, if I'm all dressed up outside and it's warm and it starts to get warm up, I start taking off layers. As we travel down the river of strange fire, as that light starts to come in, we begin to shed layers, revealing vulnerability. But with vulnerability requires trust. Trust to come out of the shadows. Trust that that light is a good light. And perhaps this is where we start learning the first lessons of discernment. We're given the first language from the birth of the mother, and we start to speak this language that we're given as we go on this river of life. What ignites the fire in you? What is it along this journey that whenever you see something, have you ever been driving down the road and you see a sign and it registers with you and you're driving down the road and maybe you're with your wife or your partner or your best friend and we get down the road, hey man, what was that one place we passed by? We need to go back and check that out. I've done that myself. I was traveling through Arkansas and I saw a sign that said something about a crystal mountain of crystal caves. And just before that, I had had a dream about being in this crystal cave. And I remember in this dream that while I was standing inside this cavern, it was huge like this. It might have been this place, and I'm just now realizing it. But I remember that with every step I took, the floor lit. Kind of like those 70s disco floors. You remember those? And in my dream, I remember, wow, this is kind of cool. But then I remember, too, my grandpa always said, look up. And in my dream, I looked up, and I was surrounded by people. And only then did I realize that not only was I thinking in my mind about what was happening in my dream, but I was speaking it out loud, and people were listening. So again, the deja vu moment's coming back to me in this moment. Reliving a dream that ignited a question in me, ignited a fire inside of me. I have found in my dream time, and to my Cherokee people, we have always believed that the other side of consciousness and awareness, the balance of life, is consciousness as we're awake as human beings. We walk the earth, we go to jobs, and we do what we do. And the balance of that consciousness is to go into rest. We have light, we have darkness. We have up, we have down. We have awake, we have asleep. We have conscious, we have unconscious. And perhaps it's in this unconscious moment that the embers of memory begin to ignite the fire. To ignite the fire of the water that we drink that nurtures us, that quenches our thirst for the questions that may not entirely answer our question, but at least we can take a drink and we can feel sated. We can feel appeased in these moments. Not appeased, maybe, but at least heard. And in times whenever organized religion, as we have learned in so many other factions of beliefs and sections of faith, sometimes we can be misguided. Sometimes some of the people that are out here sharing these truths perhaps should sit with the truth a little bit longer. I know I'm one of them. I know I'm one of those people that I've had this idea and man, we need to have a million-man march, and we need to do it now. And there's no planning involved. But the energy's there, right? Okay, so whenever we start to go into this moment, a strange fire, does it feel strange for us to speak our voice? Why is it now, just like in these prayers that we see on the prayer wall here, our community wall of prayer, maybe their only voice is to be able to say it silently. And maybe it's the silence that ignites their fire. And maybe their fire can only be ignited because maybe they can't find it in themselves to find the courage to be vulnerable on the journey. To even show up. Have you ever gone someplace and know that you needed to be there, but it was hard to be there? Have you ever sat in a church or a ceremony and heard the message and, man, why is he talking about me? What was that, Tevi and Fiddler on the Roof? I know we're your God's chosen people. What, could you choose someone else from time to time? It ignites our fire. So the fire is the strangeness of the horizon that we go into. We create the fire along the journey. The intensity of fire depends upon the intensity of how we absorb the lessons that we're given in life. Just like the two brothers that learned the lesson of taking this opportunity to work in the Christ-like, God-like self of creativity. But the very tenets that we follow here at Jubilee of creation spirituality, celebrating creation. In those times of the Bible, was it wrong for them to do it? Yes, because that was the law of the land. Of man, man-made law. But in spiritual law, where do we stand with free will? Whenever we talk about creation spirituality and the God self that lives inside of us, if we're made in the likeness of our Creator, then we are creators as well. So aren't we anointed? In the evolution of understanding, these are the things that grow. There was a time that whenever the Bible was the go-to, say all, end all thing. I grew up in the Southern Baptist Church. I know. I grew up with a father that gave me the look that could make Medusa turn to stone. The dad look. Or the mom look. I'm sure some of you got that too. But it's the energetic exchange. And we are tempered by the fires that ignite us. Some of us call them triggers. How many of you have triggers? I have them. It's a good thing some of you aren't in the car with me when I'm driving, somebody cuts me off. And I have to learn that the fire that burns inside of me and in those moments of laughing at myself and humbling myself to the moment. Yeah, I can feel that fire. Hey, bud. But almost instantaneously, I can find, also, I know where that fire comes from. And I can temper that fire back into a place where it becomes a place of love and compassion. Whenever we put these obstacles out in front of us and the sun comes into it and the fire burns it and tempers it, it's no longer glossy and blurry. Once we temper it to such a wonderful place, it becomes a perfect window into the future. It becomes a clear window to the past. Just like looking into the water that we look to feed us, to quench our thirst for the mystery of life. So do we move forward knowing that we're anointed? That we were anointed whenever we came out of the womb of our mother, and that first breath that we took, the Creator saying, welcome. Welcome to the river. Welcome to the river of strange fire. Welcome to a life of discernment. Welcome to a life of challenges. Welcome to a life of success, idea success, recognition of success. Can we take the language that we've been given in silence? How many of you find peace and serenity in the silence of the woods? How many of you love to dive underwater and just... Stories are being told. The rivers are running. The fires are being ignited. Our desire to journey into our gift of free will is being quenched. So let's remember to drink from the well of life. And whenever the fires get hot, let's not deem them bad. Because sometimes, what is it they say? No pressure, no diamonds. And if you're going to be a star in the sky, we're going to have to endeavor to persevere with what lies true in our heart, with what ignites the strange fire in each of us, each and every one of us, and how in the end, as one indigenous tribe of this earth, all the tributaries that come together that make the larger body of the ocean that feeds the body of earth, that feeds the vibration so that when we walk barefoot upon this earth, we receive the love and the compassion and the dreams and the visions of all that are gathered, just like we are gathered right here. We are the fire that's been ignited, Jubilee. We're the strange fire because we're here to be vulnerable in our compassion and benevolence to those that are looking for such things. For those that can't make the bullets stop flying, and for those that can't make the hunger go away, and for those that can't look at a clock and say, okay, it's time to quit, they're looking for us. So don't let the strange fire scare you. Know that it's necessary in order for us to evolve and to reignite. And we can reignite that fire to the point where it gets so hot that it smolders and it molds us back into oneness. After all, isn't that the journey? Isn't when we join with the other rivers that are flowing out there of love and compassion and strange fire and undecidedness and confusion? We all have it. So let's embrace it in a good way. Let's take it and polish it just like that clear window, and let's temper it with the heat of our love, of how the light receives us and how we reflect the light. Just like looking into that telescope out into the wonders of the universe. Where did that wisdom come from? It came from the human standing and looking out into the sky and saying, how can I get there? And we've been given the wisdom to create these lenses and telescopes so that we can come closer to finding out there what lives inside here. So let the river flow in whichever direction you choose. And know that it's us together that will keep it alive, and that we will continue to be able to quench the thirst for those that are calling out looking for our love and our compassion and our benevolence. This is what Jubilee is about. This is what the main thing is, the main thing. When we look at the prayers on those walls for all of those looking for prayers for their depression and for their loved ones they're missing and for their dog's operation and for those that just don't know what to ask for, but they're asking anyway. That's why we're here, Jubilee. That's why I'm here. That's why I carry these ancient ones with me so I can remember. So in a good way, let's remember to give gratitude to one another. When you look in the mirror, tell yourself how much you love yourself. Speak to yourself just like you're the mother and the father, that womb child that's being born and formed, and encourage yourself to grow, and encourage yourself to ignite the fire of strange, this river of strange fire with your goodness, and let your light shine so that when those are out there in the universe looking to us, they'll be able to see us shining in a good way. Woo! Man. And we're back. It's still me. Where are we here? Okay, that was me sharing. Yes, okay, we're going to offer our gifts to God. And before we go into the music of this aspect, and for all of you that are out there online, I want to just share a moment with you of how much we really do appreciate you being here and taking the opportunity to, in your life, to help flow the fire that's growing here at Jubilee. We ask you to contribute if that is something that you're moved to. And we ask you to know that we honor you and that we thank you for all that you do in your presence and for taking the time for being here. You are so precious to us. We love you in a good way. Jubilee, part of moving into the future is ritual and ceremony and honoring. And here at Jubilee, we like to, again, thank you and honor you for your gifts and recognize you for all that you do. All that you give helps to for us to be here, not only for the people that you see here in the band, but also the people that are hanging up here in these flags with their prayers and their hopes for the future. And those prayers that have been written on the prayer wall there and all the candles that have been lit, know that this money goes to support that. The core of who we are, not what you see here on this screen, but the spirit and seed of what we're growing. So I offer this four times. The first time for the past and the prayers of our ancestors. The second time for the present and our understanding of now. And the third time for the future, for our hopes and dreams and visions to be seen and realized. And the fourth time, the free will to accept. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I hope.
I don't know. it was